Previously on
show with Mr. Host Announcer, and we new candidate Lin-Manuel Madison himself. Be on the lookout for criminal Shane Golden. Notable crimes include killing of God.
King William Frederick George III, what are you doing here?
Yeah!
I shall become King of America.
Governor Andrew Jackson.
I will be King of America. Populism. Yeah, yeah.
Here's some news from timeline. 5'2", rated 256, 6'9", 26 miles. The timeline when Leonardo da Franklin invented time travel and where John Brown wasn't given the death penalty. We are now in the studio. Hello and welcome back to the late night show where I, as always, am Mr. Host Announcer. Today we have some footage from the new Civil War documentary from Reporter Filmmaker. And then we later have Henry David, yes him, who is promoting his new book, Walden, a book about walls, and his sponsorship with Hip Tea. Hip for you, hip for me, hip for tippies. But first, here's the weather.
Oh. Host Announcer, I need your help.
Weatherman.
Host Announcer, I need your help.
Who are you?
My name is Nikola Tesla, and I come from the future. Or rather, the past. Or the future of the past. It doesn't matter. Me and Leonardo da Franklin need your help to defeat the United States President Andrew Jackson.
Why do you need my help?
Well, I have an idea called the Assassins Initiative. The idea was to bring together a group of remarkable presidential assassins to see if they could become something much more. To see if they could work together when we needed them to fight the battles that we never could. Since you killed President Lin-Manuel Madison, we have had our eyes on you. You, President. Jackson has already stolen four of the five key tokens. The Trail of Tears, Spoil System, the Bank War, and Populism. He just needs the notification crisis, and he will become the ruler of the world.
Wow, that's crazy. What's even more crazy is that I don't have a family to feed. I have to end the show. You know, it's kind of important. I have Henry David Thoreau coming in 8 minutes, and now I have to fight the president. With the assassins.
Ah, but I have a time machine. I can get you back in a minute from when we leave.
You do.
Hurry up! We need to find Gato and Czogolz to the booth of time travel!
Uh-oh, editor filmer, can you please roll the clip of the document that I'm supposed to be showing?
You've got it, boss.
Reporter filmmaker, and today we will be learning about the Civil War. However, this is not a documentary. It's more of just like six main topics that are woven very loosely to create something semi-cohesive. I only chose six because the people who are paying for this documentary have stolen my children and have my house. And I said I had to do six topics, not five or seven, six. They were very persuasive. Firstly, I would like to discuss the most sad part of the documentary first so that we can gradually get less and less depressed as this goes on. Cue sad music. Thank you. Now we will be discussing the Fort Pillow Massacre. And I'll be showing some really quickly over like me talking about it.
Fort Pillow was a Confederate fort taken over by the Union Army earlier in the war. It was located in Memphis, Tennessee. On April 12, 1864, the fort contained 550 Southern Unionists, Confederate deserters, and African Americans. That morning, the Confederates surrounded the fort and attacked. They attacked the fort for hours, and with the weak structure of the fort, Confederate General and Grand Wizard of the KKK, Forrest Gump, demanded for the Union to surrender. Union General Bradford sent out for reinforcements and demanded an hour's ceasefire. The reinforcements never came, and General Forrest attacked the fort again, giving them only 15 minutes to run. As they ran, the South killed almost 300 Union soldiers, most of which were free African Americans and escaped slaves, all in less than half an hour. Only 14 Confederate soldiers.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise, you are such a great general for the Union, Mr. General William Sherman.
Oh, why, thank you. Though my friends Crump, my good friends drop the bean, you know what I'm saying?
Anyway, can you please tell me about the Civil War for my documentary?
Well, it all began in the Battle of Bull Run. But I thought that out later when Mr. Blanken told me, you need to be a good second in command. And we won, but I was beginning to feel crazy. And I'm not crazy, I swear. Oh, I sound sick, Confederate soldier, so how can you be so empty and shut? You're just going insane, man. You got problems now. So I went west, so for General Grant, and became a major general. And the battle soon began for me to chill out, man. And I was chilling on the coast, and we attacked. Taking Tennessee and Mississippi and getting like that. Now that was good. But then you see, the voices in my head back and back and back again. Let's destroy the South, let's fight for a while. And I was chill, man, chill. We got out enough, and then they said, let's connect the war crime. That was fun. And I was like, no, why are you talking about it? And then they said, the war like you were talking about with Lincoln. They finally come back to the Union. No, I said, but at what cost? I would cripple the country. I'll give you a cookie. Deal, I said. Oh, that was a good cookie. And so we went down to the fella. And all the way to see, I burned it out down to scraps and destroyed the building. And I made them pay for all the blood we shed. I killed 2,000 with my own hands.
Oh, that's really great. That's really interesting. And
you think it pays, don't you? You'll be my 2,001st.
Well, this is great, but I guess I still have a better segue to talking about our next topic, the Red Cross. Here is their promotional video.
Hello, I'm Clara Barton, and I'm the founder of the United States Red Cross. Here at Red Cross, we help to take care of soldiers sick from battle and help them to receive only the best care. Here are two doctors taking care of a patient now.
Hello, I am Dr. Justin.
And I am Dr. Kia.
And we both got our medical degrees during the quarantine remotely, so we know all about how diseases spread. And we know the best medical practices of all.
Just cut it off.
And here, our patient, Mr. Reporter Filmmaker, who is suffering from the almost always fatal syndrome of General William Sherman. So we are going to cut his arm off.
Yo, future editing Jack, can you please, add blood and stuff in post? Thank you.
No.
Thank you so much for agreeing to be here, Robert E. Lee, and be a part of this documentary.
Why, thank you for having me, so that I can finally tell you and the world how much the South has been wronged.
But you started the war, and you owned people,
Think about what you're about to say very carefully, and remember that I was the cause of the bloodiest days in Civil War history, at the Battle of Antietam.
What I was trying to say was please, carry on.
Well, you see, my father was a general in the Revolution. My wife is a granddaughter of George Washington, so I knew that I was born to rebel and leave my mark on history. After I helped rebel against the Mexican Empire, I knew it was the right time to do what the South has been wanting to since John Calhoun.
Invent barbecue, collard greens, and cornbread?
No, to rebel against the harsh North, where the tariffs and improvements only focused on themselves, trying to take away our property and their foolish hypocritical moral high ground. Who do they think they are? Obi-Wan Kenobi? My slaves like being slaves after I beat them hard enough.
I have a very important question to ask you. Some of the North believes that you're a racist. Is this true?
That is impossible. How could I ever be racist? I have white friends.
Okay. So what did you actually do in the war?
I helped win the battles of 2nd Manassas, Fredericksburg, and Chancellorsville, and killed 43,000 Union soldiers in the battles of Gettysburg and Antietam.
So before I say anything that might anger you and almost die, like my run-in with General Sherman, I'm gonna
You talk to General Sherman?
only to get both sides of the...
You're cheating on me and Sherman? With the Union? How dare you?
I hurt so much. At least that's the last human interaction I'll have for the remainder of this documentary. Videos can't hurt you, can they? Now, we will be discussing Abraham Lincoln, the 16th President of the United States, a poor kid from Kentucky who became one of the most influential presidents of all time. He won the election in 1860, and his promise to stop slavery the South caused the South to succeed later that year, causing the war. He just wanted to preserve the Union and take back the Confederate States because, as he put it so eloquently, teamwork makes the dream work. This caused the Civil War. During the war, he gave two momentous documents. One was the Emancipation Proclamation, which freed all the slaves in the South. I know that's not true, Miss Peacock, but it's easier to, like, wrap it up and all that. You know what I'm saying, right? You do. You got me. Thank you, guys. Anyway, and the second was the... Thank you, Mr. Betts. Now, as I was saying, it was after one of the bloodiest battles in American history to try and lift the spirits of the Union soldiers, to remember why they fought. Here is the original draft of the speech which Abraham Lincoln is performing in his bedroom.
67 years ago, somebody once told me that according to our new laws of aviation, there should be no way for a being to complete the fitness ground pacer test. It's a multi-stage aerobic capacity test that gets more difficult as it continues. Why do they call it an oven when oven the cold of out-eat the food?
And to finish off this documentary, we will be discussing the music of the Civil War. We will have a very special guest performance by Clari Bishop. However, I would first like to talk to you more about the music so that you get like a background knowledge. You feel me? Music seemed very important to the people who fought in the war, a way of distracting against the harshness of America's most deadly war, as I have tried to do with all the jokes, trying to make it a little bit lighthearted. Both sides of the war had their own songs to help them get by. Songs such as Maryland, My Maryland, and more importantly, Dixie idolized the ideals of the Confederacy, and Dixie stuck around a lot longer to help fill the South with a nostalgia after the war. The Union sang songs against slavery and for President Abraham Lincoln. We are coming, Father Abraham. And another song they used to sing is John Brown's Body.
Yo! Oh no. Yo, guys! Did the song say my name?
John Brown, you're supposed to be in prison.
Nope. That's what the government wants you to think. God actually saved me from the prison system of the corrupt demons, so I could feed the slaves.
Cool. So how's it going in Kansas? I heard that's going really well.
I gotta go.
Anyway, here is Clari Bishop.
Today I'll be singing a song that united both the Union and the Confederates during the Battle of Fredericksburg, Home Sweet Home.
Made me cry. Now I think this is where I need to end it. The people with the gun and cameras say that I must be going now. Actually, I'm kind of glad that they stole my sweet dear son's baby, infant, child, and Greg were stolen from me.
My sweet child!
And now that I was forced to do this for my research, I've learned one thing very important. It's that this documentary ends. Maybe the real Civil War was the friends we made along the way. But hey, that's just a theory. A history theory. Thanks for watching.
Hello? I'm here to do the late night show with Mr. Host Announcer Man. You know, to promote my book and my tea brand. What's going on, man?
rule, we're no strangers to taxes. You know the rules, and so do I. A full commitment's what I'm thinking of. You won't get this from any other tax collector. It's
gonna happen.
What the balls of this
time? Andrew Jackson!
Forcer!
Host announcer!
Begin!
I have the nullification crisis. I finally got to Tang Calhoun. I am now Emperor of the World!
No!
You failed, host announcer. Your channel is ruined. Nobody likes you. I have everything I need. You barely killed a presidential candidate. I will kill you. You have nothing. What do you have?
I have the power of friendship on my side. Assassins, assemble!
Wow. What a crowd. What do you have that I don't?
I have an acting degree. Seek Semper Tyrannus.
I have the power of God and anime on my side.
That's a name that very few people can say. It is Czogolz. It is not that hard.
I've got an umbrella, stomach pains, and a book of conspiracy theories.
I have a spicy meatball.
I have the power of alternating current on my side.
I've killed God. I'm not afraid of you.
My dear friend Shane, there's something you forgot to remember.
And what is that?
I am God. How is that for the power of friendship? Is that all that you have left? A crazy Serbian who loves a pigeon.
I am a world-renowned scientist. I invented electricity, remote control, Wi-Fi, and death rays.
What is so funny? I don't understand your American humor.
I just find it funny. Seems alternating current does kill. I'll send Edison your regards.
No, Pigeon. I don't feel so good.
Now you have nothing left. No friends. No historical figures to wrap up their lives.
What have I done?
You have nothing left.
I have one thing.
And what is that?
A gun.